Makes. It's Ashley from Ashley Makes It. Welcome back to my channel. I know you're probably thinking, didn't she already do an intro with that whole setup? And the answer is yes. I am mass doing intros today, so you'll see this shirt, this hair, this background a few times for the next couple weeks. Don't be alarmed. Also, my background changed recently because I moved, you guys. So I'm no longer in my apartment, which means you won't get to see the wall of hairspiration anymore. It is officially gone. And I'm actually going to be selling the wall of hairspiration on my Facebook channel. I'm sorry, my Facebook page on the Ashley Makes It Facebook page. If you want to buy the wall of hairspiration, you can pick it up on my Facebook page in the shop. Today I have my number one requested video. Yes, you guys. So everybody wants to know, how did you make the wall of hairspiration? Everybody just so enamored by them. They think it must be like a really, really hard DIY or something, but it's not. I made the wall of hairspiration over 5 something years ago. Yeah. And it was a super, super, super easy DIY to do. You only need a few different supplies that you probably already have in an hour tops to do it. And so, not even an hour, 30 minutes, probably even 10. 10 if you're not a perfectionist. I'm a perfectionist, so it takes me a little bit longer. So, today that's what we're going to get into. I'm going to show you how to do it, what materials you need, and how you can customize it to make it your own. So, if you're interested in seeing that, just keep on watching. Oh, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already subscribed. If you have subscribed, go ahead and click that notification bell so you never miss a post from me. All right, let's get to it.
Okay, so the supplies you need are going to be your canvas, your picture, scissors, Mod Podge, and a sponge brush. So it's pretty, and I mean really, really simple. We're literally just gonna glue the picture down. So get your picture. It needs to be just a little bit bigger than your canvas. This is just a regular size printer paper type photo. And now we're gonna take our glue, our Mod Podge, and we're gonna put a generous amount of Mod Podge onto the canvas. And spread it out kind of thinly. You're gonna want to put a couple layers before you put your photo on, and be patient with this process. I wasn't all that patient, and you're gonna see what happened. But take your time, and you're probably gonna need like a flat credit card or a room key card, like a hotel room key card, or one of those little roller thingies to help smooth out bubbles. I didn't remember to do either one of those things, but it'll definitely help your photo come out smoother, neater, cleaner. But if you don't have one, fingers work just as fine. You do want to keep in mind, however that you set this, is how it's going to dry, is how it's going to show up on the canvas. So if you see those little wrinkles, those bubbles, if you don't smooth those out when it dries, you will still see those bubbles. So keep that in mind whenever you're doing this DIY. How you start it is pretty much how it's going to end. Be sure to also put a generous amount of Mod Podge on the corners and fold them down so that they can be glued down as well. You just want to do the same thing all the way around. And make sure to seal your ends with the Mod Podge. So it's okay if it gets a little messy. That's not a big deal. It's a good idea to go ahead and rub any excess Mod Podge right back onto the canvas so that you can help seal everything off. And I'm just wiping down my table because I got glue everywhere. So now I'm just repeating that step with the corners, making sure that I get everything covered. But as you can see, it's really, really simple. Once you're completed and it's dry, it's gonna look like somebody did it professionally for you. So just finish up and do each side, being very generous with the glue. It's okay if you get it all over your fingers. You know, it's water-based, so all you have to do is head over to the sink and wash your hands. Everything will be perfectly fine. And it won't damage any of your surfaces either because, like I said, it's water-based. So this side has just a tad bit more excess paper. And I'm kind of folding those ends like a Christmas present. And you can do this however you choose. Some people like to cut those ends. I started to do that, but it was simpler to just fold them over. And I'm going to go ahead and add a little bit more glue so that I can glue down the extra paper on the back of it. That way I can seal the edges as well. The goal is to make sure that you seal those edges so that they do not fly up. They do not come up. They do not, you know, roll up. You want to make sure those edges are flat down to the canvas and that they do not move. Because if those edges start to come up, everything will. So the last step is to go ahead and seal the top of your canvas with the Mod Podge. And this just to protect your photo, your picture. And you can do this technique with any kind of photo. Like this is my logo and I just printed it from a regular old printer using a regular old copy paper. But you can do this with photo paper. You can do this with cardstock, whatever you have. If it has a picture on it and you want to do it, you can do it with quotes. You can go ahead and do the that same technique. And if you want to, you can either just cut down the photo to be the exact size of the canvas so you don't have to worry about folding the edges over. I just prefer this method because it seems to be more secure in my opinion. And this is the end. You guys see how easy that was? And this is the wall of hairspiration. Do you guys remember it? It used to be above my desk in my old apartment. I just mounted it on the wall really quickly here so you guys could see what it all looked like together. I'm actually going to be selling the wall of hairspiration on my Facebook page in my Ashley Makes It shop. So if you want to get the wall of hairspiration, I'll probably charge like $5 a piece. Nothing much. And you can have the wall of hairspiration for yourself. Oh, and here's a quick runner tip. Use, those are just little push pins instead of real nails. They don't leave big holes. And giveaway time. So for this giveaway, I'm pretty much giving you guys your own DIY starter kit so you can make your own wall of inspiration. You know the deal, like the video and leave me a comment. Last but not least, this is the winner of last week's giveaway. So congratulations. Hit me up to let me know that you won and I will be sending you your $25 gift card. For the giveaway, you have to like the video and leave me a comment. And remember, make each day a great day. Now go be great.